tremendous economic benefits. I'll show you the graph in just a moment, but we're projecting Massachusetts ratepayer wholesale energy cost savings averaging over $120 million per year during this time frame. There are also obviously a lot of local economic advantages from this plan, stable long-term tax revenues for Salem, construction and a number of construction jobs. I think at our peak we're at over 500 construction workers at the site, and highly compensated operations jobs at the plant. And this will provide, bringing this plant online will provide an anchor tenant for the development of the rest of the site. Will give us a lot of flexibility, having dealt with Salem's tax needs, immediate tax needs, to then be creative with the city of Salem about how we develop the rest of the site to maximize its potential for the community. Whoops, I do want to show you this. So this is our projections on wholesale savings these are in millions of dollars. And so you see, this is Massachusetts sitting here, and these are the projections. We get up to about 150 there in 2019. The dips that you're seeing are based on changes in load, new facilities that are projected to come on. This is projecting high levels of renewable coming into the system, which is our hope and aspiration, and also the state's. So you're seeing, there's some dips and valleys as you're going along, but really sustained high levels of wholesale cost savings for Massachusetts. Now, it's also interesting to note that the savings are even more massive system-wide, because the pricing is based, it's a New England pricing. So you're showing across New England altogether, you're showing almost $300 million there on a couple of years of savings. So I will entertain questions on this later, but I do want to get to some of the more interesting aspects of what you're actually going to see on the ground. This is Salem Harbor today. This is taken from Collins Cove. It's a somewhat unusual vantage point of the plant, but you can see we have this is a 492-foot stack. This stack is something on the order of 400 feet. This little stack here, which is actually the retired stack for Unit 3, is just under 300 feet. 300 feet. And then there's the powerhouse underneath, and the coal conveyor, and all of the equipment takes the 65 acres. This is the much more constrained footprint of what will be there when we are done. These are the gas turbines and the heat recovery steam generator, which is a way of using the waste heat from the gas turbines to then drive steam turbines, which will sit here, air cooled condensers here. What we've been trying to do in developing this plant is address a bunch of different concerns and needs of the community, both from a visual perspective, from a noise perspective, obviously from an emissions perspective. And so everything that we've done, all our layouts have been intended to accomplish that. We didn't think we were going to be hard enough on ourselves in that process, so we actually hired someone who would be even harder on us. Bob Fox is sitting here. You might raise your hand, Bob. Bob is our architect. He's used to building skyscrapers like the Bryant Park, the one Bryant Park Bank of America building in New York, which I believe is the largest LEED Platinum building in the world. Is that still the case? So we like to be hard on ourselves, so we brought Bob onto the team to make sure that we were whipped into shape. And really, all of our design and layout decisions are made with an eye to being respectful to the community and to the needs of the community, and even to the architectural precedents that Salem has provided. Here's the plant that we are proposing to build. I think we charged Bob with coming up with an iconic design concept, and we think he's succeeded in spades. It's a little hard to see, but basically what we've done, what Bob has done, is to reduce the massing, simplify the forms, create the, you know, through these louvers, transparency between the more massive structures underneath and the sky. Obviously a much lower stack. I'll get to a different picture here, which maybe you can see better. Here you can see the stack is much lower, it's 230 feet rather than the 492 feet. Again, you know, just really trying to be responsive to the community in terms of its visual needs, its sound needs, keeping the noise levels down, and also creating some softness through this berm structure that surrounds the plant and hides some of the lower levels of the plant where you know, the forms are not so simple. Really creating a facility that the community can be proud of, that footprint can be proud of. This is our first project, hopefully our first project in a long line of projects. You know, we were formed with the intention of dealing with this crisis that the United States has about its coal plants and what to do with them, and what their host communities are going to do. And so we are, you know, we're proud to be here. We're proud for this to be our first project. We're grateful for the support of all of you in the process of getting this done. And I think with that, I believe I'm done. I can open it up for questions, Robert, if that's okay.